Recently, I finally got my second camera up and running, and I think it would be a massive understatement to say that we've definitely been putting it to good use in the streams. But with a standing area and a second camera comes a lot of room for innovation. And I wanted to make some new digital sets to really put it over the top. So this week I made a kitchen digital set for whenever we do food related stuff on the live stream. And I recorded the entire process. So this video is a little over 6 hours of work condensed all the way down to just 10 minutes. And I've narrated the entire thing to sort of explain my workflow. That being said, let's get started. My name is Chris Folea. I'm your stream scholar. Welcome to Stream School. So the very first thing I do when I start any digital set is make sure the digital camera's sensor size, focal length, and actual position in space match that of my real world camera. Then I also shove in some references for where I'm going to be standing and where my back wall is, as well as an actual picture reference of myself so I can model the scene around me. Then here, I went on Google and found some reference for a really cool oven for a kitchen set. I just think I searched retro oven or something. And I found this one, and then this is just pretty much box modeling 101. And the proportions don't matter 100% here, but I did go to the picture, but I did go into my kitchen and measure the height and width of my actual oven using a tape measure to make sure it matched and felt correct. And you'll notice that I use a lot of really destructive modeling techniques here between all of the bevels and the n-gons and just the messy geometry in general. And I wouldn't recommend that in an actual production workflow, but since I'm the only one touching these scenes, if it looks correct, it is correct because nobody else has to mess with this. And I like to get these scenes done as quickly as possible because I have a whole bunch of stuff to work on. But overall, I think we turned out with a pretty cool looking oven, and I decided here to do a glass top instead so it feels more modern instead of just like the regular metal cross-hatching burners. It's also a lot easier to do. Here, I wanted to find a cool tile texture for the walls, and I tried a whole bunch of different things and looked through the substance repository. But I ended up just using a bump mat from a brick texture that I already had on a solid white wall to make it look sort of like painted brick, which you'll see a little bit later. And here I just started laying out the scene a little bit more, making sure I knew where the cabinets were gonna be. And I realized that I was standing smack dab in front of the oven, which was not great since that's like one of the primary set pieces that needs to look cool. So I moved that over. Then I continued to make the glass stovetop. And when I'm texturing things, when I need something that would normally be textured, like those stove circles, sometimes if I can, I'll just model them on to save time. Here I added in the wall and the brick tile pattern, and I decided to do a two-tone wall with the white bricks and the wall behind it. And whenever this pauses for lengthy times, I'm literally walking over to my kitchen and I'm taking my tape measure out and measuring things, like how thick is the granite, how deep are the counters and all of that stuff. And I decided I was going with a blue and white sort of color scheme for this kitchen. So I grabbed like a silver, gray, whitish granite and put that as the countertops, and then decided to make the cabinets of blue. And I wrote down the measurements for the cabinets from the real world in terms of inches, just so I wouldn't forget and just so I wouldn't get that wrong. And then I started modeling that out. Here, I wanted to use my typical signature bubbles on the wall, but I just could not get that color to work. It just would not look good with the retro blue that I really liked on the oven. So I decided to resign and just go with a plain colored wall, but I added a little bit of wallpaper texturing to it just to break it up some, add some variation because it didn't look very realistic with just being solid blue. Then here's some more modeling and texture manipulation, but mostly modeling on the cabinets and adding the handles and everything. And again, I literally measured all of this stuff out with a tape measure to make sure it matched the real world sizes of things. And I decided at this point that this was gonna be an L-shaped kitchen, and the wall would be where my actual kitchen in real life is, since I'm not walking over there, and the chat on stream is generally gonna be there. Here, I added the cabinets into the scene and just messed around with the position and sizing of those. Used the same colors, but most kitchens have cabinets above the counter, so figured that would be a good detail to add. And here I decided to, I think, get rid of the second oven and add some dials to the main oven just to add that really cool detail behind me in the scene, just to make it more believable. I didn't get rid of the second oven quite yet. Oh, there we go. There I got rid of the second oven and messed with the positioning of it all just to make sure I wasn't standing in front of anything too cool or too interesting. I wanted it to be sort of bare behind me so I could focus all of the detail on areas that people would actually see. And here I was just looking at more reference and just tuning the scene and adding detail and tweaking things. When I'm working on these scenes, I'm a little bit all over the place. It's just sort of, what can I work on next? What can I work on next? What can I work on next? Like there I added a cutting board that I got back to later because I decided I wanted to add a logo to the scene, which I wanted to find some cool fonts to use for a Cooking with Chris logo. So I went to Google Fonts, which actually has like hundreds of really solid open source fonts that you can use. And I knew I wanted the with Chris to be sort of curved up in a cursive font and Cooking to be more bold and sans serif. But I couldn't get it to work quite well until I messed with adding a knife there. And here I could not get the lowercase g to work for my life. So I decided to just add an apostrophe and make it Cooking with Chris. And here I modeled the knife, the handle and the knife blade weren't too bad. The knife blade was a little bit more challenging than originally anticipated because I had to model the actual sharp part. So I had to do some cuts with the knife tool there just to make it look like an actual knife. Move everything around, model the detail. And here I added the text to the scene. And I retopologized text by just making it a bunch of n-gons and then insetting the text so I have clean edges to bevel. I don't worry about the topology for the interiors of the text at all, though. It doesn't really matter. Here I noticed the with Chris font wasn't actually connected when it came in, so I decided to just manually trace that with Bezier curves, however you pronounce it. And that was a lot of work and a lot of effort. It took a decent amount of time, but in the end, it's worth it for the payoff. I think it looks really cool. And I didn't even end up having to convert this one into geometry. I just kept it as a curves object and used the bevel and extrude tools there. And it worked out pretty well. It ended up staying pretty clean. It looked pretty good. And I messed with the colors there, ended up with a white and a black, which I later changed to have wood, kind of like a wood specular highlight texture on. And here I'm messing, speaking of specular highlights, I'm messing with the cabinets, and I didn't want to unwrap all of these and add an actual wood texture because that would have taken a really long time. So I decided to just use a procedural noise and mess with the scale of it using an object-based coordinate to sort of just break up the specular. Nobody's going to notice it's not real wood since I'm literally only using it to break up the specular some. Here I found a tileable wooden texture for my cutting board. I like to use tileable materials in these scenes a lot of the time rather than manually texturing everything just because they're nice and reusable and it lends itself to the fast workflow really well. Obviously, I have to import my fish logo into the scene somewhere. And here I decided to add some wall outlets. If you look in your kitchen, you probably have a lot more than you originally thought you did. These took a little bit longer to model than originally anticipated, but it's one of those details that you notice if it's not there, but you don't really notice if it is there if you do it properly. Again, I measured this to make sure it matched the real world size. Measuring things is very important. And I added 6 here. I actually have like 14 outlets in my actual apartment kitchen. I tried to get the bubble texture to match again, but I just couldn't. So I resigned and made the wall just a little bit different color. And I decided I wanted some stuff to hang from the wall, like various pots and pans and kitchen things. So I modeled this using just a cylinder, some spheres and toruses, and some cubes. Shoved that rail there. Then I started messing with the scene again. I'm all over the place, but you notice I opened some of the cabinets and drawers. If everything is too perfect, that makes it look CG and not believable. So just slightly tilting doors open, slightly opening drawers lends to the believability of the scene for sure. So I messed with that a lot, and I had to model some interiors to cabinets. Here I wanted to make a pan to hang from some of the hooks on that bar we just made. And this is where I realized that an 11-inch pan was too big, so I had to go with an 8-inch one. And this, again, is just basic box modeling 101, except it started with a cylinder and a cube for the handle. And shoved that on the hook. I thought that turned out looking pretty well. I just used solid colors for all of the materials on that, but I thought it looked pretty cool. And here I decided to make a metal bowl to hang from the other one, which I ended up actually just duplicating to the third hook and making it plastic for variation. And a little bit bigger, of course, but Yeah, I thought that looked pretty cool, just adding additional detail to the wall there. And then I added another pan to one of the stoves on the oven, which I spent more time than I'd like to admit, just fiddling, trying to figure out which burner to put it on. And here I'm just going around the scene, adding additional details, making everything look better, filling empty spots. The one empty spot is pretty much where I'm gonna be standing. I decided I wanted a knife block here, just because it's a typical thing you would put in a kitchen. And I figured that that wood might match the cutting board. Maybe they came together in a set at the store, who knows. Move everything around, tweak everything, make sure it looks good. Added an HDR for lighting just to get a little bit more blue tint in there. And then, mess with the textures of some things, add some glass texture to the oven, add an interior to the oven. Then I decided I wanted to texture the knife and add some actual detail to that. If I spent more time on this, I could probably make it look a little bit better, but overall I'm pretty happy with how it looked. Do a little bit more tweaking with the lights and the materials and everything, and this is pretty much done. This is where we ended up. And tweak the lighting a little bit more and render it in cycles instead of Eevee, and we end up with something that looks like this. And I've gotta say, I'm honestly always really impressed with how close I can get with just Eevee. I mean, Cycles is obviously gonna be more realistic with the bounce lighting and the nicer reflections, but having that Eevee rendered preview up while I work is honestly so useful. Anyway, if you wanna see my Blender work in use, come hang out with us live every Tuesday, Friday, and Saturday at twitch.tv/oraclefishlive. And if you found this video interesting or helpful, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button below the video for new content every single week. Until next time, my name is Chris Folea, I'm your stream scholar. Class is out.